Well, we can do any touch and goes with Waukegan, or we just skip that.
If you want, we can go with us if we're there.
Let's skip that.
All right.
Let's just focus northeast departure over the lake, slow flight, and installed. Mm-hmm. One moment, please. Okay, forget Waukegan. I'm not going to move the touch and goes today. Besides, you got to go to work at 10.
Yep.
I have it at 8:18. Okay. Before starting engine, packet hobs have been recorded. Seats, belts, shoulder harnesses are on. Fuel shuttle thumbs on. Radios, transponders, electricals are all off. Click your breakers. All right. Car feed is off. Mixture is full rich. Primer, 3 times, because it's cold. Slow, because I want the cylinder to stay. Winds are from the west at about 7 knots, 5 to 7 knots. One.
That'll probably give us another 2-4.
One more time. Throttle open 1/4 inch. Done. Master switch. Brakes are on. Master switch is on. Rotating beacon is on. Nav lights on at dusk. Propeller area appears clear.
Approach runway 16 east. Landing and departing runway 16 24. No chairman? Yeah, I left the runway 16 is out of service. Doesn't need to contact QBA, destination Bravo. Chicago Executive Airport information, Bravo. 13520 the weather. Wind 260 at 8, visibility 10, sky clear below 2000. Temperature 01, dew point -01, altimeter 3026. GPS approach runway 16 in use. Landing and departing runway 16 24. No chairman? Yeah, I left the runway 16 is out of service. Doesn't need to contact QBA, destination Bravo. Chicago Executive Airport information, Bravo. 13520 the weather. Wind 260 at 8, visibility 10, sky clear below 2000. Temperature 01, dew point -01, altimeter 3026. GPS approach runway 16 in use. Landing and departing runway 16 24. No chairman? Yeah, I left the runway 16 is out of service. Doesn't need to contact QBA, destination Bravo.
Okay, I have can you hear me okay?
Yep.
Excellent. And this is all plugged in? That's straight?
It's working, yeah.
Excellent.
1000, temperature 01.
Okay, no worries.
Right there.
All right. I have ATIS. We got winds from the west at 8 knots, visibility 10. Everything is clear. The altimeter has been set.
This is out of service. Thank you, ATIS. Information Bravo.
My transponder's on standby. I see
that
we have full fuel, both wings. Everything looks good. I don't see anything out of whack. I'm going to call it in.
Landing and departing runway 16 24.
Executive Brown, Cessna 6001 Golf at Area 2, requesting a northeast departure. ATIS, Bravo.
6001 Golf, Executive Ground, clearance runway 24, taxi via Bravo.
Runway 24 via Bravo, 01 Golf. Hey, you were right. That's very prescient of you that you knew that. But then again,
I can see the windsock there.
The windsock? Where's the windsock?
Right in front of us. Right where the hangar's at?
Yes.
Between the car, the red car?
Yes.
And the hangar?
Yes.
There's a windsock.
I see that windsock. You are a genius, sir. We'll check our brakes, yes? Yes, yeah. One more, please. Brakes work.
All right.
Brakes work. Excellent. Excellent. Short line. One moment, please. Cabin doors and windows closed and latch. Thank you, sir. Flight controls check movement. Okay. Elevator trim is set to takeoff position. Excellent. Brakes are on. Throttle at 1700. Love that throttle. 1700. Engine instrument suction's okay, fuel's okay. Oil pressure's in the green, oil temperature's in the green. Magneto's checking the right. Slight dip, both. Left, slight dip, both. RP checking for RPM drop. Excellent. Ammeter checked by splitting the master, but not the battery. We are charging the battery. Throttle retard to idle. And then set back to 1000. Right to idle. Back to 1000. Splendid. Flight instrument, flight instruments. Altimeter's been set. This guy, a bit concerning. I fixed it before. Now it's gonna be right in the middle. Alright, so the heading situation indicator matches the compass. Let me check. Flaps are up. I see nothing else that requires any adjustment unless beacon light is on. Unless you see something, I think everything's okay. Radio set the tower. You ready?
Yep.
Transponder is set on altitude at 1200. Landing lights on. Flaps are up. All right. Okie dokie artichokey. I'm going to get a knee board sometime within the next couple of weeks. Ready?
Yep.
Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, holding short of runway 24, ready for departure.
Cessna 6001 Golf, got runway 24, clear for takeoff, turn right northeast.
Runway 24, ready for departure, turn right northeast, 01 Golf. Slow. Don't go in the grass. Ready. Are you ready?
Yep.
One moment, please. Rotate. Nice day.
Up. Nice and clear, crispy day.
Maybe a bit too bouncy for my taste.
Only gonna get worse.
That's nice. Feet, getting ready to make my turn, gentle. Are we going over the runways?
Yep, you're okay.
Alright, good. I don't want them upset at me.
They'll be more upset if you go on that side, because that's the approach. If you go over the runway on this side, the planes are going to be landing lower than you are, right?
Okay.
As opposed to being all on that side where they're higher.
Okay, so I see the two black hotels there with a white building. That's a marker. I believe that that area, those structures up ahead by the lake, on the, that's Fort Sheridan.
Alright.
I'm going to hit 1800 feet until we get over the lake, then I'll hit 3000. Oh, a little bit of a bumpy ride there. Speed's holding steady, and 1800. Beautiful day.
Executive Tower, this is Skyhawk 3532 Uniform, over Lake Zurich, inbound for land with Bravo.
You concur that see the white building in the
3532 Uniform, exact tower, continue inbound, expect runway 16.
That's for sure.
Yeah.
Inbound, expect runway 16, Cessna 3532 Uniform.
Cessna 33 Uniform, squawk 5105.
Squawk 5105. Cessna 3532 Uniform.
Executive Tower, Skyline 746 Quebec, holding short 2-4, ready to depart.
7463 Quebec, is your on course heading 360, or what are you planning on doing?
About 350.
Okay, that is the exact opposite of all our IFR traffic. We only have one approach, and that's to runway 16. Can I suggest either a little more northeast or more northwest?
I understand, no problem at all, sir. I'll go west of the tracks.
6-3 Quebec, runway 2-4, clear for takeoff, turn right
north. What the
fuck was that? Quebec, clear for takeoff, 2-4, heading to the northwest. Thank you.
Damn. Did I mention how I hate turbulence?
In the wrong business.
Should we be doing the slow flight with turbulence like that?
Yeah, we could do it.
Alright.
We'll see if it gets smoother up at altitude.
Okay, I'm concerned that I'm at 2,000 feet already.
Yeah, right, because you're beyond that Lake Cook Road.
Okay.
So you're outside of that little shelf.
Okay.
Wind 270 at 10.
There's another little cocoon right here, you see that?
Yep.
That's where the indoor golf range?
That's about where the Bravo ends. I mean, where Delta ends right here.
Really?
Right around here. Okay, so you're right here.
Yeah.
That's where the Bravo ends.
Yeah.
And that pie was over here, a little bit further south.
Okay.
By Lake Cook Road, so.
Uh-huh.
And that's 2500 anyways.
What kind of cell phone is that? Is that a Samsung?
Oh, this is an iPhone.
iPhone, I'm sorry. Oh, for the fourth flight, yeah. As soon as we cross into the lake, I'll hit for 3,000 feet.
Yep.
Splendid. Should I go straight east or head
north? Let's go straight out that way and then we'll face towards the shore.
I see a drone or something heading, or it's a bird, sorry, heading your way. Sorry for 6 feet back.
You want me to go, once I hit the lake, you want me to go straight east?
Yeah, climb up to 3,000 and then turn back eastbound. I mean westbound.
Oh, yes. Oh, fuck, turbulence. I'm in the wrong business.
Okay, you can start your climb here.
Pointing my nose, okay? Not too far above the horizon?
Yeah, right there, that's good. That gives you about a 500 foot per minute climb.
Good.
That's where you want to be.
Excellent. So what's the scoop next week's Thanksgiving?
3-3 uniform, surface wind out 270 at 1-1. Did you want 1-6 or would you like another runway?
We have 2-4 if you don't mind.
3-3 uniform, good. Right traffic, yep. Runway 2-4.
Are you going to be out of town or what? 2-4.
Hey, what?
923. Are you going to be out of town or what?
No, I'm asking you.
I'll be here. Thanksgiving's on a Thursday, right?
Yes, of course. So who cooks the turkey at your house? Does mom cook the turkey?
Yeah, she always does every year.
Yeah? Does she do a good job?
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Never complain.
23 uniform, runway 24, clear to land.
Runway 24, clear to land, Cessna 3533 uniform.
Nice view, beautiful view.
Cessna 63 Quebec, no other traffic at this time, you can proceed on course.
Roger that, 63 Quebec, thank you.
Leveling off slightly. Another 75, 50 feet. Today. Okay, we're at 3,000.
All right.
So I'm going to make a turn heading towards.
Give yourself a 180 degree clearing turn.
One moment, please. Gaining altitude, which I don't like. No, I'm gaining altitude. Trim down.
Yep.
Trim down a little more. And begin my rollout so that I'm heading due west. Yes, sir, due west at 3,175.
Okay, whenever you're ready for the slow flight, you remember you have to maintain plus or minus 100.
Okay. One moment, please. Alright, can we consider that I've done my clearing turns?
That was your clearing turn.
Fabulous. Okay, so first things first, I keep gaining altitude, I don't like that. So, carb heat is out, and then down to 1500 RPM. Beautiful. Now the whole idea is you want to keep the nose up, so I'm going to do a little trim.
Wind 270.
I need a lot of trim.
No worries.
All the way down.
No worries, don't want to lose any altitude. A little bit more of trim. A little bit more of trim. Well, trim's all the way down.
Okay, you're losing altitude.
Power, a little nose up. point to that rudder.
10 degrees of flaps.
Yes, sir. 10 degrees of flaps. Beautiful. I've lost more than 100 feet, so I just screwed that one up.
Yep, you gotta add power and get yourself up. Add power. Pitch up. I wanna hear the saw horn.
I'm fighting it, I'm fighting this plane. Gotta release a little pressure from the trim. 50 knots. I'm past 2,000 RPM. I should lower my RPM, shouldn't I?
No. Bring the nose up. That's what you're
doing. Whoa.
Bring the nose up.
Okay.
Okay, that's going to get you into that, where your altitude's supposed to be at. You
got, right.
Right there's a stall horn. Over
power.
There. No. All you got to do is just bring the nose down slowly.
Okay.
Right there. You don't have to add more power.
All right.
Add 10 more degrees of flaps.
10 more degrees of flaps.
See, you're right where you want to be. Now that flap's going to bring your nose up again.
Okay.
So bring the nose down just a little bit.
Yes.
And you're at 1,000 now.
3,000. Yes.
Okay, so now you trim it out for that. Trim it out for the 3,000.
We'll be going back to Hangar 6 with 3-3 uniform.
Test 3-3 uniform. Taxi 286.
I'm gaining altitude.
All right, push the nose down, bring the power back.
Hangar 6, remain with you.
Just the power a little bit. More.
2,000 RPM.
All right, right there.
I'm pitching.
Bring the rest of your flaps down.
All the flaps?
Yep.
30 degrees, 40 degrees.
Bring the nose down, bring the nose down.
It won't look like this tomorrow, will it?
Okay.
Clear. Dry.
45 knots. 3,075 feet.
Keep the wings level.
Ooh.
Don't let yourself go to the side or anything like that. Okay, give me a turn to the north.
One moment, please. That rudder.
Okay, I want you, you're going to do an imminent stall. It's going to be the first indication of a stall. Okay? So what is? How do you get the first indication of a stall?
Well, the stall horn.
Yeah, stall horn or the buffeting and the
yes.
Stall horn. Okay, so how are you going to do the stall?
You want me to do a stall?
Yeah, but how? Explain to me how you're going to do it first.
Well, I'm going to, all I got to do is basically pull back on the nose. I mean,
you're gonna reduce the power completely, right?
Okay.
And then you're gonna lower that nose like you're coming into a land.
Okay.
And then you're gonna lose 100 feet, and
yeah.
Then you're gonna pitch up. Coordinate it, okay? That ball has to be in the middle, and the wings have to be level. You're gonna pitch up. When you hear that stall horn,
okay.
Then you're gonna lower that nose and add the power and full carburetor heat and power in. Okay.
All right, I'm at about 20.
All right. Don't jerk it. Don't be a jerking with that. All right, let's do it now. Okay, so take the power out. All out. Completely out. Now you're going to lower that nose. Lower the nose. 100. You lost 100 feet.
Yes.
Now bring the nose up. All right. You hear the stall horn?
Yes.
Stall horn. All right. Lower the nose. Full power. Full power. Don't hesitate on that power. Add the carburetor heat. Don't jerk it around, just keep it right there where it's at. Then 10 degrees of flaps.
At 30.
Keep climbing out.
We lost a couple hundred feet.
Yeah, you're going to lose some altitude. Okay? You're losing 100 feet because you're coming down automatically. You're coming down for that maneuver. And then you're going to lose another 200 feet on the actual stall.
10 more degrees of flaps.
Yep.
Gone.
And then you're going to lose some altitude with the recovery. That's why you have to do it at this altitude. Back up to 1,000.
We gotta do that again, I fucked it up.
Alright. You want me to demonstrate?
Just, we'll
work it together.
Okay. Yeah, you know what I mean.
I see you jerking around too much, you jerk too much. You gotta keep that, as soon as you hear that stall horn, just bring the nose down gently, add that full power.
Okay, we're heading due north at 2,950 feet. Let me get another 50 feet, 25 feet, 3,000. Okay, so pulling back the power, okay.
Carburetor heat.
Carb heat is on.
Pull back the power.
All the way?
To 15.
To 1,500.
Maintain that 3,000.
I'm pulling back.
And then add the flaps.
Okay, so I'm gonna trim those down.
Yeah.
I mean, turn those up.
No, just this is good.
Okay.
Just add the flaps.
10 degrees of flaps? Ooh, I'm at 20 already.
Alright. Oh. About a mile up.
Alright, I'm 10 degrees of flaps.
Alright, just... Okay, now take the power out.
All the way?
All the way.
Power's gone.
Pitch nose down.
Pitching the nose down.
All the way out.
Out.
Okay. Alright, you're gonna lose 100 feet. You're coming in, the runway's right in front of you. You're coming in for the approach, right?
Right.
Pull back. Pull back. Back, back. Back, back, back.
Nose down,
below the horizon, at full power. That's the critical part, full power right away. Okay, don't hesitate on that power. Keep the nose down, right below the horizon. Okay, carburetor heat goes in simultaneously. And now one notch of flaps above 70, you got your last notch above 70. Okay, that's it.
All right, we gotta do that again.
All right.
We gotta do it again. Okay, so... Are we heading towards where we're busting into Waukegan's airspace?
No, we're okay.
Okay. I've trimmed the nose back down to level so we don't gain more altitude. Alright, so as follows. Carb heat out. Throttle to 1500. We'll be reducing power. I mean reducing speed. And 10 degrees of flaps. Right away.
You can put them all down. Bring them all down.
All right. RP is on. Throttle's at 1500.
Maintain that altitude.
I got it. 1500.
Okay. Bring all the flaps down.
Bring them all down. All right. My altitude is holding steady.
All right.
All right.
Okay. All right. Now you got a 3,000 feet?
Yes.
Take the power out?
It's out. Oh, okay. All the way out.
Coming down 100 feet?
Yes.
Keep the wings level?
Wings are level.
Okay, start pitching up.
Pitch up.
Stay coordinated. Alright. Pitch up. There's a stall horn. Pitch down.
Pitch down. Power.
Power. Carb heat. Don't pitch it up because you're going to... You hear that stall horn going on again?
Yeah.
That's a secondary stall. You don't want that. You want to just keep the nose down so you don't get that. Just keep it below the horizon.
All right.
Maybe about 4 inches below the horizon. You
okay.
See that? Something like that.
Okay. Flaps up.
Flaps up.
10 degrees.
All right. Another 10. Okay. The last notch is above 70 knots. Put the nose down just a little bit. Right on the horizon, right there. Airspeed's coming up. You can put another 10 degrees up.
Only 10 degrees less. Oh!
Alright, now we're at 70. You're gonna, okay, now you can bring the rest. That's it.
Got it, okay. Alright. A little crappy there, but that's okay. You want to do stalls?
Huh?
You want to do stalls?
That was a stall.
No, I mean power on, power off.
That was a power off stall.
Power off stall.
Okay. You think you got it or what? That was an intimate power off stall. Now we're getting close to Waukegan now.
I'm going to make a 180 so we go back south.
Head west and give me a 360 steep turn.
One moment, please. We're 3,025 feet.
So we can maintain that altitude.
We're heading straight west. What do you want now?
Give me a steep turn. What's a steep turn? What does that consist
of? I think it's like 60 degrees, isn't it?
No, it's
45
degrees.
So this is 30,
yeah.
And that's 45?
No, that's 60. 60.
So
and
between.
That's and between that those two big lines.
All right.
That's 30 and 60. Okay.
Okay, here goes.
Maintain that 3,000.
Steep enough, I'm only at 30 degrees.
And that's plus or minus 100 feet also. Yeah, you're not steep enough.
scared to go past 30. Okay.
Right there. Look at the horizon. That's your main key.
Okay, 45.
Right there.
Our turn is coordinated. I've got the... Ooh, not too much, not too much.
All right. Okay, you pass your 316.
That's fine. I don't care. That's fine.
You don't care, but the examiner's going to care.
I understand the examiner's going to care.
He's going to say 316, you go 720, that's not...
All right. Let me...
It's not passable.
Well, okay, yes, sir. Okay, we're at 2950. Let me get up a little bit more. We're heading south. Okay. I'm going to do a 360 now. Steep. Coordinated.
The horizon is your key. Okay? You'll see it slice through the same angle all the way through the maneuver.
Even more, huh? Even more? Even more?
Yeah, that's only 30.
Yeah, 30 I can do, but 45 scares the crap out of me. That's 45, or 30, 45. I'll just keep going.
No, that's not the point. The point is you got to roll out on a designated heading.
I'll have to roll out on the west.
Okay, let's stay west, okay? Let's do this. Do you want me to show you how to do this?
Okay. Unfortunately, yes, I do want to.
All right. This is a hard maneuver. A lot of people don't feel comfortable with it.
I don't. It's too angly.
Okay. So you're at 3,000. And
yes.
What you're going to do is you're going to look at that horizon slicing. I got a different view than you do.
Yes.
The horizon's got a slice at a certain angle.
Yes.
Okay? And I'm looking at it. It's going to be right through here.
Yes.
Okay. So I got 3,000 feet.
Yes.
And I bank. Okay. I might add a little power if I need it. Okay.
All right.
There's a 45. There's a 45 right there, and I'm banking all the way through, all the way through, all the way through, maintaining that altitude. And then I'm going to roll out on that west heading. Now, I use a cardinal heading, and I look at the roads out there, too. And there's my west heading, and I'm rolling out, and I lost some altitude.
Yes.
But not more than 100.
All right, okay? Let me give it a shot. And on throttle, my plane?
And the heading has to be plus or minus 10 knots.
The heading means 10 degrees?
Yeah, 10 degrees, yes.
All right. We're at 3,000 feet. Pick a direction, left or right?
Huh?
Pick a direction.
Give me right.
Right turn.
I could tell you're losing altitude. You're going to lose altitude because... Put the line... Right on the same angle all the way through. Yeah, that's better. But now you're losing altitude. Don't add more power. Because if you add power, you're going to steepen. It's going to be more G's. But it's going to be harder to...
Getting ready to roll out.
Okay, there you go.
Boom, baby.
There you are. See, that's passable.
Holy smokes.
And you got your weight, too.
Holy smokes, that's terrifying.
Yep.
All right, what do you want to do? What do you want to do?
Let's go back to executive and do a couple of landings.
Touch and goes.
Let
me get ATIS.
1352 Zulu weather. Wind 2608, visibility 10, sky clear below 2000. Temperature 01, dew point minus 01, altimeter 3026. GPS approach runway 16 in use. Landing in departing runway 16 and 24. No chairman, the ILS of runway 16 is out of service. Please contact KPWK information, Bravo.
Did he say runway 16 is out of service?
ILS is out of service.
Chicago Executive Airport Information, Bravo. 1352 Zulu weather. Wind 2608, visibility 10, sky clear below 2000. Temperature 01, dew point minus 01, altimeter 3026. GPS approach runway 16 in use. Landing and departing runway 16 and 24.
Boom!
No chairman, the ILS of runway 16 is out of service. Please contact KPWK information, Bravo.
ILS is out of service.
Okay. I'm going to start losing altitude.
Chicago Executive Airport Information, Bravo. 1352 Zulu weather. Wind 2608, visibility 10, clear below 2000. Temperature 01, dew point minus 01, altimeter 3026. GPS approach runway 16 in use. Landing and departing runway 16 and 24. No, sir. Port Sheridan. Service. Just contact KPWK information, Bravo.
Here's the bubble.
No, that's not Port Sheridan. Oh, no. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And there's that bubble.
Executive airport information, Bravo. 13520 the weather. Wind 2608, visibility 10, sky clear below 2000. Temperature 01, viewpoint minus 01, altimeter 3026. GPS approach runway 16 in use. Landing and departing runway 16 and 24. No, Chairman. The ILS runway 16 is out of service. Please contact QV destination Bravo.
I'm trying to lose altitude, so I'm at 2,000 RPM.
Chicago Executive Airport Information, Bravo. 13520, wind 2608, visibility 10, sky clear below 2000. Temperature 01, dew point minus 01, altimeter 3026.
Ooh.
GPS approach runway 16 in use. Landing and departing runway 16 and 24.
The field is over there.
You see it over there? What you're pointing to is over here. It's a nice clear day, you should be able to see everything.
I should.
They're gonna change the ATIS.
My two little black buildings. Where are they?
Okay, what are you gonna do if you don't see the airport, if you don't know what's happening?
I have to find markers.
What's the procedure if you're lost?
I have no idea.
Okay, it's called the four C's.
Okay.
You have to climb. Conserve your fuel. That means you don't want to go too fast and burn your fuel out, right? You want to communicate, and then you want to confess. Now we're not going to go do the communication because you have me to communicate, right? If you're going to confess, you can confess to me that you're lost, right?
Well, I know Fort Sheridan. We got to angle in southwestish to get to the airport.
All right. Now another thing. If you don't know where you're going or how close you are. Where do you think the class delta is going to start?
Soon.
Where? Where do you think?
The road.
Yeah, okay. So by that road is going to be the delta starts. So I would not go past that road if I don't know where I'm at.
I think the two black buildings are straight ahead.
Okay, we can take a look, see if you want.
Chicago Executive Airport, Charlie 14520 weather, wind 270 at 9, visibility 10, sky clear below 1,000, temperature 02, dew point minus 11, altimeter 302.
Now you're at 1600, which is good because you're entering that
belt. Runway 3430.
You're entering that 1900
over here. Circle advise Chicago approach on initial contact. Landing and departing runway 3034. Chairman, runway 16 ILS is out of service. Buzz, just contact you via this information, Charlie.
Okay, I'm lost. I
Chicago Executive Airport information.
Yeah, I'm confessing. I can't find
145 degree water. Wind 270.
Look at the shore.
10, sky
yes.
Clear below 1,000.
What do you see out there?
Temperature 02,
that
viewpoint.
Spiky building.
-1.
And then the curve.
Got the high temple?
Yes, I see that right there.
Continues.
Okay, then where is that at in relationship to the airport?
IFR aircraft unable to cancel IFR prior to circle, advise Chicago approach on initial contact. Landing and departing runway 3034.
That's got to be directly east of the airport.
16
right here, right?
Yes.
The airport's over here.
Contact
so southeast.
Right?
Yes.
Okay. Another landmark.
Chicago Executive Airport.
Which is right on there.
Charlie.
You see that tower right there?
Yes.
That's directly east of the airport.
Visibility 10, sky clear below 1,000.
So why don't you go over that tower?
Go
over
it?
Yeah, go straight to it.
11, altimeter 3026.
Because over here, you're already getting into the airspace.
Circle land runway.
You're right at the edge, right here is the airspace.
Unable to cancel IFR prior to circle, advise Chicago approach on initial contact. Landing and departing runway 3034.
Also, it's a cross in the airspace if you don't worry.
Chairman, runway 16 ILS is out of service. Buzz, just contact your ATIS information, Charlie.
You got your ATIS?
ATIS, Charlie.
Okay. You got that now, right?
Airport information.
So get your tower.
145.
All right. Let's fly over that tower and then come and then face come,
yes.
this way. And you're over that tower. I always call when I do my lakeshore flights. I always call over that tower. And I'm 7 miles east of the field.
Oh, that's nice. 7 miles east is this tower. 7 miles west is that countryside standpipe that's built like a thing that with a red dot. Right.
So it's even to that on the other side. Have you ever got lost, just go along the shore?
Yes.
Look at the Baha'i Temple?
Yes.
Look at for that tower?
Yes.
North of it?
Yes.
And you can't get lost. There's a road coming right off of that. It's called Tower Road, and it goes straight to the middle of the airport.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I must be in the wrong line of business.
There's a road that comes off of it. It goes straight that way?
Yes.
Tower Road. Okay. You give him a call now.
One moment, please. One moment. Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, 7 miles east of field, requesting enter the pattern with the option.
Cessna 6001 Golf, Executive Tower, do you have the ATIS Charlie?
Yes, sir, my apologies, ATIS Charlie, yes, sir.
Cessna 6001 Golf, would you say enter the pattern inbound to land, or what are your intentions?
Go ahead, touch and goes.
Touch and goes, please.
All right. Thanks. You can just say that at first call. Cessna 6001 Golf, right traffic runway 30.
Right traffic runway 3001 Golf.
Okay. So there's your Tower Road right there.
Right.
Follow that Tower Road. That's Willow Road over there.
All right.
There's your black building over there. And that's your white.
Yes, yes, there they are.
Cessna 6001 Golf, squawk 5107.
5107, we'll be squawking. This guy, right? 5-1-0. And then ident?
Yep. He didn't say yes, ident.
Squawk it?
When you put ident, all it does is lights up the screen.
Okay.
His radar screen. But all he requested is 5107.
So I did that?
So yeah, you did that.
Why did he want me to do that?
Because there might be another plane somewhere around here.
Okay. We're at 2,000 feet, I'm going to lose a little altitude. I'm down 1,800. The field is straight ahead. Man, I hate getting lost. I really do. Climb.
Don't get lost. This area is tricky, you know?
Yeah.
And then you're so close to it. Here, look at where it's right there. You get lost and you bust that airspace, forget
that
it.
That patch, I see a runway there. That green patch, that's O'Hare.
Yep.
Jesus Christ, that's so close.
That's right. It's only 6 miles south of our airport.
Now, I'm going to, we're going to do runway 30. So I'm going to have to come, hit the middle, hang right, and not runway 34, runway 30, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to hit the angle, 2 miles out, make a downwind, not downwind, but crosswind, downwind, base final. Yes?
Like this, and like this?
Yes.
No?
No.
Huh. Which way is 30?
That way.
300 degrees is this way, right?
Yes.
You're going to be landing into 300 then.
Right.
Right.
So I got to come this way.
So, yeah, you're going to come in. You're going to go straight. And you could enter the pattern if you want.
Yeah.
He didn't say nothing. He just says, enter for 30 or whatever. He said, but you could either come in downwind, base, and then final going that way. But right now, how you're set up, you're set up for base to final.
Okay.
So why don't you just land face to final? He didn't specify.
Okay.
Cessna 01 Golf, runway 30. Clear touch and go and then make right traffic runway 30.
Runway 30, touch and go, right traffic, 01 Golf. Okay. I'm going to come down to 1,600 feet.
Okay, let's do an extended base to final.
Okay.
So now you know the runway's going that way, right?
Yeah.
So let's go this way on a base leg. Then we're going to do a long final. Right here, this is good.
do flaps.
Not yet. You're far away. You're more than 3 miles away. Flaps, you can do it. You start doing them as you get closer. Have you done a no flap landing?
Yes, we have. I'd rather not do a no flap landing. Okay, so 3-0 is going that way. Not the long one. That's 3-4.
You see it right there? 3-0 is right there.
I'm getting ready to make my turn.
I think it'll be too soon.
Okay.
Winds are coming out of the west, right?
Executive tower.
We're going to push you. If you do it too soon, you're going to start fighting.
6-1 tower.
So remember, the winds are coming this way. So you can even extend it a little bit.
With information, Charlie inbound to land.
Cessna 979 or 6-1, right traffic, runway 30, squawk 5110.
5110 and right traffic for 30.
That way, right?
That's it, right there.
I see one red.
All right, I wouldn't descend anymore until you come in a little closer, past these buildings right here.
Seems like it's such a short runway.
Wind 280 at 10.
Oh, that's fine. Okay, two reds. I'm at 1,100 feet, one red. I'm going to get 10 degrees of flaps. Reducing power to 1,700.
What are you forgetting?
Repeat, I'm sorry, yes sir. Line this up a little better. Hey, there's a McDonald's there. Boo, baby.
Don't hit the arches.
2-2-1. Shit, we're too high. 10 more degrees of flaps. That's a display threshold?
Yep.
Shit, I hate those fucking things. 10 more degrees of flaps.
Alright, now you're high, right?
Yes, pointing down.
Take that power out, completely out. Now you're gonna add a little right rudder to straighten your nose out, right?
Sure.
Keep that nose down.
Oh, fuck!
No, you're stalling too. You're flaring out too high. Alright. Hey, the winds are coming from this side, right? Keep that control this way. You never brought the flaps up, man. I never brought the flaps up. Alright. We got the flaps. That's why I took off so fast.
Zero-one golf, left traffic when able.
0-1 golf, left traffic. So 1,100 feet?
Yep.
I blame the wind for that.
We're flying too high. Okay. On a crosswind, I like to fly right over that runway a little bit. Right before I touch down, I like to flare. Right before the wheels touch it. Runway, I like to bring it up.
My problem is the runway is so short, I just don't...
No, it's not short. It's a long runway. It's a 4,000 foot runway.
It looks short to me.
If you're that short, wait till you go out to the country. I got the 2,000 foot runways.
Oh, that's fun, thanks. What's our time? How long have we been in the air?
About an hour.
Okay. You want to do one more touch and go and then a final?
Alright, we'll do that. Your nickel.
Say what?
It's your nickel.
Not nickel, more like dollars.
Just 97. 361. Number 2 to land runway 30. Number 1 aircraft opposite downwind, just south of the field. I'll call your base if you don't have them in sight.
Center 7961, number 2 to land, have traffic in sight.
Cessna 01 Golf, runway 30, clear, touch and go.
Runway 30, touch and go, 01 Golf. The 1700.
Don't forget your flaps when you land, alright?
Wind 280 at 10.
20 degree up crosswind, and it's only 10 degrees, so it's going to be tough. Alright, start your base. Not too far. There's somebody else coming in. Alright, lift your wing, look at the runway. Alright, watch your airspeed, it's starting to decrease. That nose down.
I see the buildings.
Start your turn because it's gonna wanna push you from the away from the center line and at this end. All right.
10 more degrees of flaps. Pointing down. I see 4 whites.
Executive Tower Tiger 1190, one ready for departure 34 Northwest.
Tiger 90 Victor Tower, runway 34 line of wait, traffic landing, departing crossing runway.
That's us.
Runway 34 line up and wait, 90 Victor.
Cessna 01 Golf, traffic holding position on the crossing runway, no need to respond.
No need to respond.
You're too low, look at, you got all red lights.
Fucking.
Winds are stronger up here than they are down at the ground.
Dude, right, that's the last 10 degrees of flaps. Right about now. All flaps are down. Are you ready to kill the power? Pointing down.
Not yet. Don't kill it yet. Clear these buildings first and then start bringing it back.
Killing the power,
right.
And pointing down.
Right. And you're just going to fly 1 foot above the runway. Okay, there. 1 foot.
RP's in, flaps are up. Full throttle.
Alright. That was better than the last one.
Thank you.
But you landed before the threshold line.
I know. Rub it in. Rotate.
Cessna 961, runway 30, clear to land.
Clear to land, runway 30, 961.
Tiger 90 Victor, Executive Tower. Turn left northwest, runway 34. Clear for takeoff, X-right departure, traffic inside a mile final, crossing runway.
90 Victor, clear land 34 northwest.
90 Victor, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 90 Victor.
Says 01 Golf, left traffic.
01 Golf, left traffic. This will be a final stop, please.
Right.
It's supposed to rain next Saturday too. I was looking at the extended forecast.
Check your schedule before we leave.
Cessna 961, where do you park?
We'll be going to Hangar 5.
961, left 24, cross 34, Hangar 5, remain restricted.
Left on 24, cross 34, 961.
Cessna 01 Golf, runway 30, clear to land.
30, clear to land, 01 Golf.
You just passed 24, 961, and now you're going back. Okay, that's 24.
What the hell was
right
that?
Turn, cross 34.
What the hell was that?
Sorry about that, 961. I thought that was a taxiway.
No problem.
Somebody screwed up down there?
Yep, that's that guy right there. He's taxiing down 2-4.
That's nice. Okay, it hit an altitude. Almost beam the numbers. Beam the numbers, carpe out. Flaps 10 degrees, 1700.
Stop! 961, stop. Okay, okay, you're on Delta now, 961. Taxi straight ahead on Delta. Traffic is landing 30, you're heading towards 30. You're okay now, 961, go forward to Hangar 5.
Straight ahead to Hangar 5, 961.
That's the, that's Bravo airspace starts over there.
Right.
Don't want to bust that.
Zero Tango Mike, runway 34, line up, wait traffic, landing, crossing runway.
All right, line up and wait, 34, Zero Tango Mike.
Zero Tango Mike, runway 34, clear for takeoff to the west, no delay, traffic on final.
All right, clear for takeoff, Zero Tango Mike.
That's nice, right into the wind. All flaps. Red.
I'm going to red you dead, man.
Don't want to stall.
Watch the trees down here. Add power, power. Don't descend, because you got your trees like 20 feet below you. Alright, that's good.
Okay.
Clear all these buildings here. Okay, you're gonna have a little bit of right rudder because you cocked it left a little bit. Little right rudder.
Oh, fuck!
Not too much right rudder. You're at too much right rudder. That was good. That was good.
Okay. Okay.
That was perfect.
That was bullshit, but I'll take perfect. Executive Tower, request Area 2, please.
Take it, please.
01 Golf requesting Area 2.
01 Golf, Bravo Area 2, remain this frequency.
Bravo Area 2, remain this frequency, 01 Golf. That landing was okay?
Yep. That was a good landing. You had that tire to the left side. And
right here.
You flared out pretty good.
Right here.
Yep. The only thing I noticed there is that you jerked the right rudder too much.
Yeah.
Bring it in a little slower, you know, just don't be too jerky with the pedals and everything.
I'm glad one of us knows what the hell's going on. I don't see any cross traffic, we're fine. And this frequency. Yeah, so tonight and tomorrow's gonna snow like crazy. So that's why I canceled. I would have preferred having the lesson, but we won't be able to go off. It'll be snowing. Let's check your schedule before we call it a day. Let's check your schedule for like next week.
You got Thursday. I mean Saturday, right?
Of course, I have my typical Saturday, but I mean that's recurring. But if the weather's gonna get fucked, I mean I'd like to have a back to back if that's possible. But also it would give me the insurance of at least having a lesson. So if we don't have it Saturday because of the weather again. So the first landing here sucked. second landing was, what, passable? Drivable?
Yeah.
The third landing was okay?
Yep.
Good, glad to hear that.
Got better as you went along.
Hey, that's nice. I like that. I like that. Dokey.
The first landing could have killed you because you didn't bring your flaps up.
You wouldn't have let that happen, though.
I felt, I thought you had them up, but I felt how the plane just lifted, you know?
Funny how that works.
Something not right.
Funny how that, those aerodynamic crap works. Okie dokie. Not bad. Stuff to learn. View. And one moment, plane. Line this guy up. We're lined up. Okay, so. Another day, another dollar. One moment, please. One moment. Sit down. Nose wheel is straight. Radio electricals are off. The electricals are off. Back to 1200 as a courtesy to whoever's flying. Righto. So this is goodbye. Then lights, throttle, mixture, aisle cut off, ignition switch, beacon lights off, master switch off, control lock install. So, goodbye.
Oh god, that's exhausting.